Good morning, guys. Welcome back to a brand new weekly vlog. This morning I am coming at you with a bare face because, and like I'm half dressed. I've got my urban crop on and my new Primark straight jeans, which by the way are amazing, but I did try them on in the darker denim in this size 8, and they're a completely different fit, so I recommend trying them on. I am going to try, I ran an Instagram poll last week about a new YouTuber I have discovered, Gina Shook. Her channel is amazing, and she's done a couple of videos recently about like natural makeup, which I'm all about. I tend to wear mostly natural makeup anyway, so I thought I would do a little play on one of her makeup looks, which Jamie Genevieve has also done, and it's her video is called Fake Beauty. It's this one. I mean, she's gorgeous, look at that. So I'm gonna create some fake freckles. What she does is she uses mousse, but I've got two. I've got a self-tanning mousse from Norvell. They also do a face tan, so I'm gonna maybe use a little bit of this and see how we go. And I'm just gonna use a pencil brush. I just have this one. I'm not actually sure where this is from, but it's in my makeup collection, so I'm gonna give it a whirl anyway. And I'm gonna do some faux freckles. Leave them on for 5 minutes. And then come back and finish off my makeup. Here goes. My battery's about to go as well, so if I cut out and cut to the next scene, you know why. Okay, this looks pretty crazy, but by the time you've covered it up and wiped it off, which I'm doing with just like a tissue, because you don't want too much like product or anything, or tonic waters or cleansers to take it off. But as you can see already, it's a lot lighter. For a little bit of primer, I'm just going to put on some Smashbox Cosmetics Photo Finish Foundation Primer, and I'm just going to focus this on my like T-zone. I'm also only going to be using my fingers to apply products on this kind of like more natural, although I usually would use a sponge. This Real Techniques one is very well used, as you can tell. I just feel like with a tiny amount of product, with a more natural look, fingers is better because it just works it into the skin even more so than normal. The warmth of your fingers just kind of like warms up the product, makes it easier to use, and I still want a few freckles to show through like that, so just a very light coverage of this. It's BB cream, it's the Clarins BB cream skin detox fluid. I use this every day, and then I'm going to put a tiny bit of concealer under my eyes, but I am actually quite liking the under eye circle thing that's going on at the minute, so literally just a tiniest amount here of my Lasting Perfection Collection. My favourite concealer. And then if you had any like blemishes as well, but my skin's pretty clear at the minute. And then I'm gonna take a contour stick. This one is the Pure Cameo Cosmetics Contour Stick. It's double-ended, but this concealer end I've finished already. I'm just gonna put a tiny bit in there and again work it in with my fingers. Just whatever excess is left over on the sides of my nose. And I always like to put a bit here under my lip just to give the effect of a fuller lip. Tiny bit of Hoola powder bronzer just to kind of use as a powder base more than anything. So just very lightly over where I've contoured. It's very subtle. Just under my jaw and on my forehead. And then my all-time favourite highlight, which I use every day and will last me probably forever, is the iconic London in Original, the Illuminating Drops. I'm just going to put a tiny bit, again, very minimal here today. And just use my fingers again. I love this. Tiny bit on my Cupid's bow there. a natural blush in Orgasm. This is just a mini one. I've actually got two mini ones, so no point getting full size when I've got two minis. These literally last me for ages as well. It's amazing. So literally the tiniest bit, just to add a tiny bit of colour. I'm just going to use the Cabral, Benefits Cabral, just to kind of lightly underline, like just to define the line a little bit. And then also just run some of my Gimme Brow through, and I'm just going to kind of, I learnt this technique at Tom Ford in last week's vlog, if you saw. In fact, a couple of weeks ago. Run this product through backwards first, just to make sure it picks up some product. And then you can always like run it back through again. So just backwards. And then forwards. The only thing I am going to do on my eyes actually, which is what Gina did in her tutorial, is with that same contour shade, just grab a bit on my finger and just kind of press it into the lid. Just to darken it a little bit. Mascara, literally just keep the product to the ends of the lashes, like no more than that. And then if it's a bit too clumpy or there's too much product, just grab like a clean spoolie and just run that through. But yeah, no more than that, and a little bit on the bottom. Again, I have really long bottom eyelashes, but you just can't see them. So my favourite lash treatment to have done is the LVL lashes. They are incredible. I had them done before I went to Barbados last summer, and they lasted really, really well. They're kind of expensive, but I just prefer like a natural lift and tint rather than adding something to your lashes. Because I've had that done before. I've had lash extensions and I didn't pull them out, but they were just really frustrating, especially towards the end. And then for lips, I am gonna line them with, this is like my perfect nude shade. It is number 7 Precision Lip Pencil in Nude. And it's just the perfect color for my skin tone. And then take my favorite lip product, which is the Clarins lip oil, the Instant Light lip oil.
I don't know that one.
I hate it when she talks to me. That's her, by the way. Just pop a bit on in the middle. I don't know why I'm saying the middle, because I'm going to be putting it all over. But just dabbing it on like so. And then you can always use your finger just to even out the product. Just to give them like a natural dewy finish without looking like you've got any lip product on. To finish off the whole look, I've just run out of my favourite face spray, which is the NYX, but it's the dewy finish, not the matte one. I prefer the dewy, which I don't have. I literally finished that yesterday. So I'm going to use the Urban Decay All Nighter, which is actually more of a matte finish. But if I had my dewy one, I would be putting that on for sure. Oh. And that is my go-to natural look with a little bit of freckles popping out, which are completely fake because I've never had freckles in my life. But let me know what you think. Just very natural. Like I said, you can barely see any product on my skin. And then the natural eyes, like I said, you could even skip the mascara step because I did do that in last week's weekly vlog. And I kind of liked it, I'm not gonna lie. So what I'll do is I'll leave a link to the video, Gina's video, down below, because I'm obsessed and I now love her channel. So if you want to check out her techniques and how she did it, she also did a boy beat, which is like a no makeup makeup look video, which is brilliant. So I'll leave both of those, the fake beauty, which is with freckles, and the boy beat natural no makeup makeup look, down below for you to watch. I'm gonna go get some breakfast from Boo's. I'm gonna finish getting dressed and then get on with some editing today. And then I'm in Manchester this week on Wednesday with lots of exciting things planned. It's now 6 o'clock, so Tom should be setting off from work anytime now. Pretty standard for a Monday afternoon. It's just gone 6 o'clock. I've pretty much, like I said, been editing all day. I'm doing 2 videos this week, so both will be live now. It's the Primark haul and the Zara haul.
and then the weekly vlog as well. But so far this week, I think all I've got planned really out and about, sorry, I've got chewing gum in, that's really gross, isn't it? The only thing I've really got planned this week is Wednesday. I'm in Manchester and I am going to, I've got a meeting with myself and Lydia are going to meet somebody, and then we've got an event at La Mer, and then we've also got a dinner at Grand Pacific with Paul Mitchell, which is really exciting. I love it when they put on blogger brunches or blogger dinners, because you can probably sit down, get to know everyone around you, meet some new faces, so it's really interesting when I pause on this kind of a face.
Nice.
So, this evening, until Tom gets home, so I've got at least a good hour, because he's still not called me yet, I'm going to start doing a bit of a clear out, and I'm going to start with shoes, and I'm going to do it in this video because I am going to save clothes, I think, for a separate video, like for my channel, because there's potentially things that I might list on Depop and as well as donate, whereas shoes, I'm not going to sell any. I don't have any really nice designer shoes that I'm going to be selling, so I'm just going to be donating any that are in good enough condition or just spinning them if they're old shoes. So I thought I would do that with you guys on the vlog. First stage is to grab a bin bag. I also just watered the plants and tomatoes coming along nicely. That broad bean plant here is kind of drooping a little bit. We need something to like prop it up against because they grow pretty much up straight. So that is that. Right, okay, bin bag. I am really fussy with comfort. Like, comfort is key for me. If I feel like shoes are gonna rub, or if I've worn them once and they've already rubbed a little bit, I'm just gonna get rid, because rather than be persistent with them and just try and keep them because I like them, I'm not. I'm just gonna get rid of them because I'll never wear them knowing that they rub. I love a little clear out. I actually really like it. I find it therapeutic and enjoyable. So I'm gonna start downstairs. I have a lot upstairs as well. I'm just gonna go. Oh, that'll be Tom. Hello.
You alright?
Good, how are you?
Good, what are you doing?
I'm just starting to clear through some of my shoes. I've got a charity bag and a bin bag.
You're gonna try and get rid of a bin bag full?
No, I think I'll get rid of more than a bin bag full.
Oh my word.
But yeah, that's what I'm doing. Are you en route back?
I am en route back.
Oh God, this is gonna be so hard. They're still in really good condition. They've got a bit of a heel. They're comfy. So yeah, I'm gonna keep those. And these ones have got a little bit more of a heel. They're a good boot as well. These ones I will get rid of because I just don't wear them. From Topshop, they're over the knee faux, not even faux, sorry. They are over the knee leather boots with like a buckle. And I just, honestly, I find them a little bit uncomfortable in terms of like getting them on, they're a bit of a struggle. But I will donate these because they are Topshop, they're leather, they're good quality. I think these are gonna go in the charity as well just because I don't really like them. Now, these boots are so comfortable and they're kind of like a welly alternative in the winter for like going on walks and things. They're lined, they're nice and warm. I don't know why these are in here, but I'm gonna be keeping these. These are wedges from Misguided. They're just super comfortable. I think I'm gonna get rid of, just because I didn't wear them. Oh, should I keep them though? Okay, I'll keep these. These are like a staple ankle boot. They're Ralph Lauren. They could do with being re-heeled. I don't know if I've even like destroyed them to the point where they can't be re-heeled, but I do wear these a lot in winter, so I'm gonna keep them. And then I have these ankle boots, which are from Primark, which I must have worn once. I think they rubbed, which put me off wearing them again, so I'm just gonna donate them. Grey over the knee suede boots from Ego, which I like. And then in here we have a pair of Ego shoes. Oh yeah, so they actually, funnily enough, I won a competition on Twitter. Like, I retweeted this pair of shoes because I just thought they were really pretty. And I won. And so they sent me the free pair, which are these essentially. So they've got a bit of lace detail on there. That is what they look like. Now that I've walked in them, I can tell that my feet aren't secure enough at the back. And I feel, look, can you see here? Like, my foot doesn't feel secure in there at all. So I'm gonna donate these because I've never worn them before and they are gorgeous. And it could just be my foot shape that they just don't fit. So, ugh.
donate.
Right, I'm actually realizing how many things I've got to go through, so I'm gonna crack on and I'll show you my progress in a bit. What are we having for dinner? Salad. You really want salad?
Thank you.
Oh, really though? You really, really want a salad right now. I can't whistle. So we have gone for a little mini fry up, the steaks for another night. Beef and black pepper sausages. Well, they're quite thin, they're like chibladas. Streaky bacon and some scrambled eggs. Oh my gosh, how many are you having?
That's pretty mean, yeah.
I'll have two.
You'll have two sausages?
Yeah.
Ruin my life.
What are you going to do with that one? Go on, I might end up having three, you know me. Meanwhile, I have finished going through my shoes downstairs and just started, just before Tom got home, doing the upstairs. I have one bin bag full to donate, and then we're gonna have, well, I'm gonna have a couple of my chocolates because it's nice to have just a couple, like select a couple rather than have a big feast of a chocolate bar. I am doing quite well of just having one or two, being fairly good. I didn't have breakfast till 11 today.
Go on, Freya.
And then I had lunch at about 2:30. Basically, the 5-2 just went out the window the first day, pretty much. I struggled to have such a small amount of calories on 2 days a week and then eat normally the rest of the week. So I feel like I'm better off with the intermittent fasting, what Tom does, and like has a bit of a later breakfast, lunch, early-ish dinner, so that from when you finish your dinner, it's quite a long period before you get around to having breakfast. They're all like indoor plants though. Just browsing Pinterest. Oh, I can hear the sausages crackling.
Pizza wee crust.
Yeah, that's nice. Anyway, this is us for the rest of the evening, so I'll catch you probably Wednesday when I head into Manchester, because tomorrow might be a no makeup, stay in, get editing done kind of day. Hi guys, today it is Wednesday and I'm heading into Manchester now. I'm just waiting for taxi to come and pick me up to take me to the train station. I cannot wait to get my car. It's going to be so much easier just because where we live is just quite remote in terms of public transport. It's still quite a distance from Manchester, so to get a taxi is like a tenner, then a train is a tenner. The trains are still messing up at the minute. If not, there's a bus, but that takes an hour and a half, and that's a tenner, and then a tenner back, and then a tenner taxi, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, all adds up, whereas it's actually a very direct motorway route. So with a car, it takes me half an hour to get into the city, park up for, if you're parking out of the city, you can park up for the day for like £4. So yeah, I'm desperate to get my car now. I just feel like I've lived without it for too long now. So I'm looking forward to hopefully getting that at some point next week. Ow, this ring just caught me. So I'm going in to meet up with Lydia. We've got a couple of events on. We've even had to decline a couple of events because there are so many on tonight and this afternoon, which is a bit unusual for Manchester. We're usually like fighting for more events for the Manchester bloggers. So lots of exciting things happening. It's all going to be a bit rushed, a bit like here, there and everywhere. And I kind of like didn't sleep at all last night, so I feel a bit like, oh, a bit spaced out, but not with it, kind of as if I'm a bit jet lagged, that kind of feeling. And I don't know, I was just tossing and turning. I couldn't get to sleep for ages. It was the same the night before, not quite as bad though, so I was already tired from that. And then last night, I think because I knew I had things planned for today, I was just a little bit restless and my brain wouldn't sleep, which is a little bit annoying. So hopefully tonight I'm going to sleep. So yeah, that is the plan for this afternoon. Come along with me. As always, I'm going to try and pick up a little prezzy for Father's Day as well whilst I'm there before meeting with Lydia. This top, I can't link it, unfortunately. And then my trusty pretty little thing, jogger casual trousers that I always wear. They're so comfy. This little nude bralette, which actually matches these, is from Zara again a while ago. These necklaces are from, I think that one's from a brand called Aurelia, and this one as well. This one is one that my dad bought for me abroad. Rings and other stories, or Topshop, I can't remember. Let's go to Manchester and hope that my train is on. If not, I'm gonna have to get the bus in, which is fine, but
have arrived at the train station early, as always. I'm always early. I hate like rushing or like being really late, so I always just play it safe and just get here super early. Got my dad's Father's Day present, and now I'm off to designer exchange to have a look at some secondhand designer handbags. I'm on the hunt for the perfect pair of jeans. You've got a mark on you. So I'm in H&M. This one's $17.99. These two, they're only $8.99. So I'm hoping they're gonna fit, but I just don't think they're gonna be high-waisted enough. Why? Always an issue. Also, these aren't high-waisted as much as I'd like them. I usually like them above my belly button. So with a crop top, I feel more socked in, you know?
Are you vlogging today or not?
Yeah.
Yay! Back again.
I know you say that in all my videos.
I'm back again.
I'm here.
We're just in Selfridges, and I was just looking at security, was looking at me and all, but we are going to head to a nice little meeting at Harvey Nicks now, and then head back here later.
For Creme de la Mer.
Yeah. Is it La Mer? Creme de la Mer? Same brand?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Just checking. Fine.
Premium ice popsicles. This is my section. Oh no, vodka. I want gin.
And the products are actually so good. They like the quality and the innovation. So we've kind of picked out a couple of case studies, and one of the most interesting ones is Jess, who is 18. So Mark is all about making your mark. It is for the much younger consumer than what is traditional to Avon.
For any fellow Manchester bloggers out there, I don't know if there are watching, but if there are, we found a little spot. This is the library, isn't it?
I don't know
where this is. We're right by the St. Peter's Square tram stop. Yeah, we had some pictures in front of the library, and then this little tunnel is cute. St. Peter's Square. Close to where I used to live. Anyway, we're gonna have a change of clothes, head to the event in a bit, and then, which is at La Mer Selfridges, I've told you that already. Yes, it's at the personal shopping, and then we are going for dinner. A quick one though, because otherwise we're gonna get home really late.
We've got dinner after this. Yeah, thank you. Behind the scenes over here.
Oh, this is pretty.
Oh, lovely.
Everyone is doing their thing, taking photos. Walking along the beach one day, and he saw how fishermen would pick up sea kelp that had washed up on the beach, and they would rub it on their skin, and their skin, despite being in the elements of the sun, the wind, looked incredible.
Open. Open. Oh wow, it's amazing. I love that wallpaper. Wow, it's amazing in here.
We're in Grand Pacific now for an event with Paul Mitchell.
Oh wow. Hi, are you okay?
So just left the event and headed to the train station because the train, I don't want to speak too soon, but the train is now back on the 9 o'clock one, so it was cancelled earlier, which meant I wouldn't have got home till really late. So luckily it's back on, fingers crossed. We rushed back out of the event, both myself and Lydia. Our trains were both 9 o'clock, so, but hers was Piccadilly. So I rushed out and I've had enough time to get here, have a change back into my comfy clothes I was wearing earlier, get a Starbucks, and the train's a little bit delayed, so I'm very early, as always. I'm just going to enjoy this now and wait for my train because people are looking at me. Good morning. Today is fresh and beautiful day outside. It's so sunny. This morning I've literally just been editing Sunday's video. I still need to finish off that because I also spent this morning catching up on Love Island. Which, loving by the way. I thought I would show you some of the bits that I got yesterday. So firstly, I went into Molton Brown to get my dad... You're a bit on an angle there, aren't you? I went into Molton Brown to get my dad a little Father's Day present because he likes Molton Brown. And they also, the woman I was chatting to, she was really lovely and she was like, oh, I'll give you this to try for yourself. It's a little body wash in Bushukan. Very fresh, light, summery. Yes, love that. I do love Molton Brown. I also stocked up on my trusty favourite setting spray, the NYX Dewy Finish. I just ran out and it honestly, it's my favourite setting spray. Just leaves you feeling fresh face, nice and glowy. And in fact, I'm going to spritz a little bit now. So first of all, we went to meet the lady who worked at Avon. It was really lovely to meet her. She came up from London to talk through some new products from the brand Avon, but the line Mark, which we got a couple of little goodies from. The first one being this mascara, Big and Extreme Volume and Length Mascara. That's what it looks like, and the wand is like quite thick, I would say. And then she also gifted us a lipstick from the range. I think she said there was about 26 shades, and we got gifted Coral Burst, which is this gorgeous bright coral, perfect for summer. And this is what it looks like. It kind of reminds me of, where is it? It kind of reminds me of this NYX one in Morocco. Like, if you actually look at the colours, they're very similar. And I love this for, like, summertime, just to add that pop of colour to your lips. You know, I remain fairly neutral with everything, including makeup. But I do, when I'm tanned, I do always take a trusty coral away with me. And then we went to La Mer, which they introduced us to the brand because I've never tried La Mer products. I got confused. I was like, I'm sure it used to be called Creme de La Mer or something like that. It was called Creme de La Mer in some European countries, La Mer in the UK. They've now internationally renamed it as La Mer. They very kindly gifted us a little box of some samples. There is a replenishing oil exfoliator, a revitalizing hydrating serum, a little cleansing foam, the lip balm, and they very kindly as well offered for myself and Lydia to go in next week, try out their moisturizers, pick out our favorite to take home and share our thoughts with you guys. So this is what the lip balm looks like. Oh, that's nice and minty, fresh. And then also we went to dinner at Grand Pacific, which is an amazing location. It's not the one I thought it was in Spinningfields. It's a new place. Well, I say new, about a year old. Really, really cool inside. So if ever you're looking to host something or meet up with friends and you want a nice restaurant and based in Manchester, definitely recommend Grand Pacific. So this is Tea Tree. This is the Lavender Mint Deep Conditioning Hair Mask. There's a few in there, so I'll try them out. And then also from the Tea Tree range, we have a Lavender Mint Conditioning Leave-In Spray. We also have Scalp Care Anti-Thinning Root Lift Foam, which I kind of need because I always like thin hair, like I have really thin baby hairs on either side, so when I wear my hair up I hate how like big my forehead looks. But anyway, they also gifted us a back combing brush called Mighty Brush, and then three products from the Neuro Care range: a heat control treatment, a heat control style hairspray, like finishing spray, and then we also got a heat control volume foam mousse volumizer for your hair. So thank you so much to all the brands. It's a shame that we even had to say no to a couple of events just because there were so many on in Manchester, which is rare, to be honest. I have to say no to an event because you're already at others. But either way, it was lovely going to all of those events and seeing all the girls. I will catch you in a bit, but for now, I'm going to crack on with work whilst the sun's shining. In fact, I might have my lunch outside in the garden. Definitely. I have a couple of parcels, so I thought I would open them with you because sharing's caring. Oh, also my channel trailer's live. Who's seen it? I noticed there's not many views on it, but it's a channel trailer, so you only really see it when you're not subscribed to my channel, but it's only a minute long, so if you wanted to watch it and give me your feedback, that would be much appreciated. This is what I ordered for my dad, so I'm not going to open it. It's in the cellophane wrapper, but I got one of these chrome Azaros for Tom. It was actually a gift from Clarins Fragrance, and he loves it, so I've got the same for my dad for Father's Day, so that'll go with his together with his little molten brown thing. This is from the PR team. Oh my god. So I'm working on a blog post for some of my all-time favorite everyday makeup / face products, because I think it'd be an interesting read with me being fairly natural and minimal in terms of makeup. I very rarely wear foundation, which, shock, I know, seems a big deal, but when you try out the BB cream that I use from Clarins, which I think, is there one in here? Yes, there is. Then you will see why, because honestly, it's just as good coverage, but it's lighter, so it doesn't feel cakey or heavy on the skin. So I got this. This is in 00 Fair. I think they've only got a few, like 3 or 4 shades, but I always just go for the lightest. So, brilliant. Stock up on my all-time favourite. Again, two of my all-time favourite things, and they are the Lip Comfort Oils. I've got 2 shades here, Honey and Honey Glam. Honey Glam I tend to use on like a bit more of a glam occasion, whereas Honey I would just use on an everyday basis. I probably prefer Honey Glam only because I've had 1 Honey Glam in the past and a couple of the plain honeys. So I feel like that you'll be able to see here the difference between the two. So as you can see, there's Glitter Flex in Honey Glam here, and this one, Honey, is better for like every day. I literally wear them every single day, every day. The only thing, I wish they were bigger, because I literally go through them like there's no tomorrow. And to be honest with you, they do last quite a while considering how small the packaging is. And then this is the Fix Makeup that Clarins do, which I'll show you. It's basically a setting spray. Kind of looks like a little perfume bottle. I think it's really cute. Okay, this is my all-time favorite primer. Always has been. I tried a sample once of my mum's years ago, before primer was even a thing, if ever it was. And now, again, it's something that I use on a daily basis. I do like to try out different primers from PR packages that are sent. But if I were to repurchase any, my go-to is always the Instant Smooth Perfecting Touch. There was a different name for it originally, I think, but that's what it looks like. And it just minimizes your pores, like it completely blurs them out, which I have quite big pores around this area. So, yeah, it's a favorite of mine, always has been, and probably always will be. So, that's that. And then there's 2 other products in here that they have sent. The Lotus Face Treatment Oil, which again, this one's for oily or combination skin, which is my type. Like I tend to get a little bit oily in the T-zone and then drier on my cheeks. So this is a good like moisturizer alternative, not alternative necessarily, but I use it as like a after bath, after shower, evening. Soak on loads of oil onto my skin and just sleep in it. And then when exfoliating, again, another all-time favorite that I always go back to and have bought for years since trying out a sample so many years ago, is this. And it's the One Step Gentle Exfoliating Cleanser with Orange Extract for all skin types. Now, they do have different exfoliators. They have the Gentle Refiner Exfoliating Cream, I think it's called. But I just love the really, really, the fine particles, I don't know, in this that really gets in there and scrubs. But also, it smells amazing with it being the orange. Oh God, I'm so funny how I like to like keep everything in its package. These are all such exciting products for me. You have no idea. I honestly, please like try some of these. I know some of you have messaged me in the past saying that from a recommendation you've tried them out and loved them. But everybody, especially that BB cream, everybody that asks what foundation do I use, and I always say that, they're like, what, a BB cream? Yep. And it's one of those things that, like, once you try it, you're completely, I don't know anyone that's tried it and not liked it. Okay, and then also Help and PR very kindly gifted me a few goodies from brands that they work with. So this one is from a brand called Suku. It's a gel eyeliner pencil. I don't think I've ever heard of this brand. Is it Korean or Chinese? in 01 black. That's the packaging. Look how sleek that is. It's kind of embossed the brand, if you can see. And then there's also Perfectil Pro Plus Protan. Let me try and get that out. It's a Vitabiotics where nature meets science before and after your holiday with copper, which contributes to normal skin pigmentation. Okay, so these are supplements that you take daily. It's a 30-day supply and there's 60 tablets, so I guess you take two a day, and that is what they look like. This is a Australian Pink Clay Flash Perfecting Exfoliating Treatment to mattify and invigorate. Oh, lovely. Apply to cleanse moist skin and massage for 30 seconds. Avoid the eye area. Leave on for 5 minutes, then rinse with warm water and pat dry. Bedhead TG, Beach Me, Wave Defining Gel Mist. I'm going to love this. That's the sort of thing that I would always reach for when going away. There's also in here a Lift and Plump Sheet Mask. I love sheet masks. And this one's from Lancer. I will add this to my mask collection to try out next time I have a little pamper sesh. And then these last four products are all Kate Somerville. There is an Exfoliate Cleanser, see what she did there. Daily Foaming Wash for all skin types. An Intensive Exfoliating Treatment. There is also an Exfoliate Glow Moisturizer. That smells really good. It smells like something that you would, if ever you've had a facial, like, I always go by scents that I imagine if I close my eyes, if I'd feel like I'd be in a spa or having a treatment or something. Like candles, reed diffusers, everything. That's one of them. This is also, last but not least, an Eradicate Mask Foam Activated Blemish Treatment. Yay, exciting. I might have a little pamper sesh tonight and try out some of these products. Tom just messaged me actually saying that he is, when he comes home tonight, I think he might be going via the bar and bringing home some takeaway, which you didn't see last night, I don't think. No, you won't have seen. But when Tom picked me up from the train station, he very kindly brought some brownie from the bar, and it was incredible. Homemade brownie that our chef makes. Oh, so good. Sticky toffee pudding's really good as well. But yeah, so hopefully we can have a nice chilled night tonight. It's a Thursday night, so nothing too exciting planned. I'm kind of weaning Tom onto Love Island. I keep watching it in the background and he keeps like doing what he's doing on his iPad and then looking up and then like going back down but looking up. So I think he's warming to it. And we're all caught up now with Handmaid's Tale, so we're just waiting every week for it, and it's so good. If you've not seen it, I highly recommend it. It's definitely my kind of program in terms of thriller, a little bit set in the future. It's kind of an idealistic world of what could happen. I don't know, I can't even describe it. It's so good. Tom's home and he's come bearing gifts, i.e. food from the bar, which I said I thought he was gonna do. The sun has literally just gone in. You've missed it.
Still sitting outside.
What are these?
Coffee. You should put it in the flowers.
Oh, so it's not fertilizer. I thought it was chocolate truffle. Yum, truffle mac and cheese fries. And flatbread?
Rose, yeah.
Yay. Oh, you haven't gone for a salad.
Yeah.
Oh, make me feel rubbish. Well, anyway, I'm just going to enjoy it. Flatbread. Is it halloumi chicken?
Halloumi and chicken.
Halloumi and chicken. Fab. Good morning. It is Friday today, and today I have decided to come into town with Tom. He is working from Burnley today. He's working at the bar and a new place that he's working on. I knew this would happen. The alarm's going off now because Tom's left it locked. There we go. Anyway, as I was saying, Tom's working from Burnley today, so I'm going to go in, a bit of change of scenery. Right. Managed to it's turned itself off again now. So I'm gonna work from a cafe and work from there all day, and then tonight he is playing a 2020 cricket game. So whether or not I probably will go over and watch that, just because it's usually much quicker than a regular cricket match. Oh, alarm's going off again. Right. We'll see you later. Interesting music. I'm just at a place called Little Barista in Burnley. It's a cafe that I've come to do a little bit of work from, grab a coffee, and then I've been doing some charity shopping. Haul coming soon. Just in River Island, continuing my hunt for the perfect white jean. And I've got these for their wide leg.
culottes down, and this is cute too. Little crop. Okay, so these ones are fairly thick and good quality, and I'm just not sure about the wide leg. They are reduced though, £25. So I prefer these. These are the halpen ones, but I just don't like that they pockets aren't real. That's kind of annoying. This top's cute, but I'm now in Nula, and we have Yasmin, Dahlia, Halle. These look really nice, but I need them in white, and they're all reduced as well.
So I'm back home now, and I have just kind of left Tom. He's just driven off to go play cricket. I couldn't really be bothered to go tonight. It's not warm, it's not hot, it's just, and I've been out all day, so I was quite ready to get home, catch up on Love Island. So, yeah, I'm going to try on my charity shop clothes. I actually already have a couple of bags from previous trips and that one. So, yeah, like I said earlier, ready for a charity shop haul. If you didn't see my last one, I'll link it below because quite a lot of you requested a second. Also, I just nipped into Poundworld. These go in your garden. They're specifically made to be outside and they're also solar lit. I also picked up a washing line and some pegs. Toothpaste, because we needed some. And then I also got myself a power bank. I'm gonna just put my shoes back on, head out to Boo's, grab something for dinner, and then settle in for the night. Okay. Just excuse this little front hairpiece at the minute. I have no idea what's going on. I didn't vlog yesterday because I ended up having a bit of an issue because I was, well, okay, I'll tell you first of all, I had a bit, I think it's an allergic reaction to something because I came up in a rash, like all on the back of my neck and then all down the sides, each side, and like the top of my legs as well. I had some Benadryl, and I've had it in the past similar, but like quite a while ago now, where my skin does get quite sensitive to new fabrics, fabric conditioners, harsh fabrics, that kind of thing. So I always have to use like Fairy Non-Bio for that reason. The only thing I can pinpoint it to is the fact that I had told you guys that I'm doing a big charity shop haul, and I got loads of bits and tried them all on when I got home. So I had a big try-on session of all the charity shop clothes. So I think some of the fabrics, the fact that they might have been there a while, like dusty, I do always rinse them through and wash them, give them a deep wash as well before trying them on and before filming and everything like that. And I was hoping to film the video like yesterday or today and do it and then wash them all. So I tried them all on, see how they fit, and then came out in this rash. So they're all currently washing. I'm putting it down to that. On the mend, and this morning, Tom is currently getting a lift to clear the road to go and pick up his cricket stuff that he used yesterday. So when he gets back, he's gonna pick me up. It's now 12:21 and I haven't eaten yet. We were going to go out for breakfast and the lift that he was getting just took ages. So it's going to be lunch that we're going out for. So I'm just waiting for him to get back. We're going to go out for lunch. It's sunny, so I'm going to suggest somewhere in the sun. Daring to get back out in the sun, but also at the same time keeping it fairly chilled. And Tom will probably be tired and hungover later anyway, so it'll be a nice little relaxing night in, catch up on some Netflix or something. Keep waiting for him to come and pick me up and go for some lunch. Tom's bought us treats. Although I'm gonna fight for him, I think, for this one. I'm having it. I'm having it. Oh, the heavens have opened. It started raining. It's still kind of warm, but it's just like refreshing the air, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to wrap up this week's weekly vlog here. I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for next week's weekly vlog. I'm heading into Manchester this week and Trafford Centre again. So it should be a fairly exciting one. Give this video a big thumbs up if you like these weekly vlogs. Please subscribe if you haven't already. It means so much to me. And I will see you again next time. Bye guys.